Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here. We got a pretty interesting, sort of a different review today. Today we're looking at a plush Sega Genesis console made by Kid Robot. So let's go ahead, get this thing open and see what it's like. Toast. So first, the Genesis itself looks just like the original console. It says 16-bit on the front. We've got the red thing right here with the power on. We have two controller slots right here that you can actually stick your finger in. Reset button. Here is the volume for your headphones. And on-off switch. And then on the back, we have all the inputs too. Looks like a controller slot in the back. Is that a controller slot? All right, I had to go pull out my actual original Sega Genesis, pardon the dust, to be sure what that is on the back, because you can see here on the back we have these five slots, and then on the actual Sega Genesis, there are only four slots. So for some reason, this one has a controller slot on the back. And here's something else that's interesting. It says high definition graphics here on the plush, when my real Genesis does not seem to say that for some reason. I just pulled out the, here's the Sonic Mania Sonic statue that stands on a Genesis, and that one says high definition graphics on there too. So that's weird. Well, I just had to be sure, so I had to look at the original box for the Sega Genesis, and sure enough, it does say high definition graphics there on the console itself. So, yeah, I guess maybe my Sega Genesis just didn't have it, or maybe it got rubbed off or something. Anyway, back to the plush. This thing is rough. This thing is hard. It is not something you cuddle with. It's not a very good plush. It does say ages 5 and up, so it's not like all the GE Sonic plushes that, you know, are meant for teenagers, because they all say like 14 and up, 16 and up and stuff. Anyway, but yeah, this thing's not a pillow. It's just sort of a display piece, I guess. It's nice they even have detail on the bottom. Let's see, if you need help, read the owner's manual thoroughly before you connect your system. That is so funny that it even has the warning labels on the bottom. Does the real Genesis have that? Look at that. There it is. If you need help, please, you know, everything. That is so funny that they got so much detail onto this plush that even on the bottom, they have all that stuff going. That is so funny. All right, now let's take a look at the accessories that it came with. So first of all, it comes with the original three-button controller with a wire and plush little plug to insert into the slot there. Too bad there's only one, but yeah, there you go. That is how your Genesis connects to the controller. That is funny. And then the other thing it comes with is Sonic 1. Notice it does not say not for resale. There's no label on the top, but there is a cartridge slot, which I believe we can stick this cartridge into the slot. Ugh. There we go. It's kind of tight. There. How's that look? Pretty cool, huh? So yeah, considering it comes with a Sonic cartridge, I kind of felt like this was a must-have for me as a Sonic collector. Let me know what you think in the comments section, friends. Is this taking fandom and nostalgia too far by making plushes of video game consoles? It kind of feels that way to me, although I wouldn't mind having a pillow shaped like a GameCube for some reason. So I don't know, just a GameCube to me would be like the perfect pillow. That's just me though. Anyway, friends, thank you so much for watching. Have an amazing day and toast.